Now that we've created our view set, let's go ahead and test it. Minimize Atom and load up the Git bash or the terminal that's connected to our server. Just make sure that the server is still running here. You can see that my server is running just fine. And then minimize this and open up Chrome. Here we are on our Hello ViewSets list. Refresh the page and we'll see all the new options that have been added. You can see on this page, we have the new post function. So we have an option to create a new object. Click on the HTML form tag and let's just test that this works. So we'll do test. Or actually, I'm going to give it my name, Mark, and click on post. And there it goes. It says message, hello, Mark. Let's test the validation by typing a longer name than 10 characters. So Mark Winterbottom. And it says, ensure this field has no more than 10 characters. So great. It seems the validation is working. Now, because we're using a view set, view sets work based on specific object IDs. So in our view sets page, we can see the get or the list function. So this is listing the objects in our view set. This is creating a new object in our view, If we want to view a specific object, then we need to provide an ID here. So let's append one, or you can append anything you want, but let's try just one as the primary key ID and hit enter. Now you can see it's returned a what's called a detail view. So a detail view is a specific object that's retrieved from the database. So typically what you'll have is on the root view, that's just hello view set, you would have a list of the objects in the database. And usually this would be like a preview. So maybe like the ID and the first name. And then if you wanted to see more details about a specific object, you would provide the ID of that object in the URL and it would retrieve the full object from the database. This is called the detail view. From this view in Django REST framework, we can also update the object. So we provided a name field in our serializer. So let's just say we added a name Mark and we put put. It would call the HTTP put function with the details that we provided. Also, while we're on the specific object, we can do the patch. So the patch, as I mentioned before, is a partial update of the object. So just to test it, let's provide a blank JSON object and hit patch. You can see it returns HTTP method patch. Finally, let's test the delete function by clicking delete here. It's asking if we want to delete this instance. Click on delete and it returns HTTP method delete. So we can see that our view set is working as expected. Let's minimize the Chrome window and open up the Git bash, that is the one on our local machine in our project, and commit our changes to Git. Type git add to add the new files that we created, and then type git commit hyphen am, and we'll describe the changes we made. So we added create, retrieve, update, partial update, and destroy methods to our view set. Hit enter to finalize the commit. Okay, so that's how we test our view set. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.